we have waited so long for the James Webb Space Telescope to launch that being able to talk about that process in the past tense, it did launch, it successfully deployed, and it's now taken some of the first successful images. It's amazing to be able to say that. It is an incredible honor to be among the community of astronomers that get to be the first people to use this amazing facility. Cosmos Webb is the largest program selected to be observed in the first year of JWST observations. I am co-leading the survey, and since this is the largest program that will be observed, this means it covers the largest area of the sky, and we'll get to observe many, many thousands of galaxies. What makes the James Webb Space Telescope unique is its large size and the fact that it's optimized to observe in the infrared part of the spectrum. Those two things allow us to see really faint things at very great distances, so we'll be able to study and analyze some of the first galaxies to have formed in our universe's history and trace how they've evolved over time. We're going to learn a lot about how our universe initially formed, what the initial conditions were like, what physics was involved in forming the very first stars and the very first galaxies, and how quickly that process happened. I think the fact that here at RIT we are leading the largest Cycle 1 JWST program opens up a lot of opportunities for people here. Students and postdocs, from graduate students to undergraduates, will get to work on some of this very first data, be able to publish some of this very first data, and become known amongst the larger astronomical community. What I am the most excited about is finding things that we never knew to ask about. We, of course, have our own science goals and the things we're planning to do and the things that we're anxiously waiting for, but I expect that we will very soon see things in the data that we never expected.